producer Sajid Nadarwala and director Nitesh Tiwari, writer director Nitesh Tiwari. I have to start. We can all safely agree that we have to first start with Chichore. We should talk about Chichore. What a charming film, both these gentlemen, producer and director of that film. What a charming, lovely film. I want to start by asking, Nitesh sir, that was you've said that that was autobiographical. A lot of it was inspired from your own life, from your own experiences. I want to talk to you about what that's like, sort of dipping into yourself and telling, putting your experiences on screen. And I want to also ask to both of you, when you're roping in a producer, now that's not necessarily the experience you've had. Maybe you didn't go to an engineering college. What are you agreeing to? Are you able to see his conviction? Are you able to see the excitement, the conviction? Are you able to visualize the film that he's narrating to you? What are you signing up for when he's narrating that story to you? So how did this sort of marriage happen? But if you want to start by talking to us about why this was a story you really wanted to tell.
At a human level, I found that world very exciting.
Right.
I also went into IIT as an observer. I went with a lot of perceptions. Most of those perceptions were broken. They were normal human beings. I thought I would be studying with robots. But that's what happened, and it kind of surprised me. And later on, when you become a storyteller and you're looking for interesting stories, I always kept on going back to those four wonderful years. I think all of us would agree that college life is probably the best time of our lives, most memorable days. So I thought if I could take certain portions out of that college life and keep it like least common denominator, if I can cut across and keep the characters which exist in most of the colleges, maybe it would become a story which a lot of people would be able to associate with. So yeah, that was the reason why I said yes, maybe there's an it's worth giving a shot for sure.
Sajid, do you remember him narrating it for the first time? Did you all have an agreement that you were going to make whatever film he was going to write next, or were you specifically signing up to produce Chichore?
When I met actually Nitesh, he had a couple of ideas, 4-5 ideas, and I thought this idea was only just a single thought, and it meant that it's a reunion of people in a situation like this.
Right.
He said, I need to make a film only for the college guy. And I've not been in IIT, but I've done my chartered accountancy, I've done my law. I've been in a school where there was boarding. So we've somewhere connected with this life. And besides that, I have a kid who's around 15 years old now. So more than the student part, I got more attached to the character of the father.
The present day
part. Yeah, so I forgot, because what I did was about 20, 25 years back in my college and my schooling. So the part where the father is trying to be easy on this, the equation between the father and the son, what excited me more actually.
I'm going to ask you all this. What I remember watching Chichore and feeling, I know these people, I know these characters. I've never been to an engineering college, I've never been in a boarding school, I've never stayed in a hostel, but it felt like these were people that I knew, it felt like these were characters that I recognized, it felt like this was a world that felt completely authentic. And you mentioned the abuses, and I feel like that's totally real to it, that's really totally to the experience. I mean, if you put five boys in a room, and that's the language that will come out. Can you talk about that, and how much of this was based in your own experiences?
Most of the college life which is there in Chichore, in different magnitude, was all there. I could not put a lot of it in the film. There was far too many incidences, but I had to stay true to my storyline and the duration of the film. I wanted to put too many things. I wanted to, like Sajid sir said initially, I wanted to have a lot of authentic galiyan in the film, because hostel life without galiyan sounds little incomplete. But, one thing which I always follow, which I have told you also, that I make film for the audiences. And having kept galis in the film would have meant it would have got an A certificate. And a lot of kids from the age 12 to 17 would not have got to see the film.
Correct.
And the whole purpose of making the film, a big purpose of making the film, would have got defeated. So I have put galis on the college.
We put on something like
we put them so that we can get through censor board and still have a US certificate for ourselves.
Right.
But yeah, I'm happy that it, though a bit diluted, it still represents the hostel life quite authentically.
Correct.
And I mean, that was the hostel I lived in. The film, the hostel 4 in the film is actually the hostel 4.
You couldn't have been in 4, yeah, sir.
Sorry?
You couldn't have been in HS4. In H4, were you in...
I was in hostel 4.
Really?
That is H4. And the film, the hostel in the film is H4 of IIT Bombay. That's the hostel I stayed in.
In the uncool one?
No, yeah. Hostel 3 was the... And in the hostel 3 in the film is actually hostel 3.
Right.
I shot in authentic locations. The grounds are the grounds I played on.
Wow.
It's like I was very lucky, and the reason I found very lucky is कि वो जो hostel है ना अभी भी 92 में ही खड़ा हुआ है बेचारा. उसका कुछ ज़्यादा development नहीं होता, मेरे को ज़्यादा production design में नहीं करना पड़ा कुछ. I just had to go and shoot. It's still same.
How many of those characters are real? How many of those are? Because I saw on Instagram actually, you put up after the film released, you put up pictures of all your friends who were watching it in different parts of the world.
Yes.
And these are the real mummy, yes. And these are the real,
yes.
Anni and all of them. Yeah.
Yes. They are all real guys. Although what I've done is I have merged multiple personalities into one guy so that he becomes more dynamic,
right.
Rather than keeping one trait of one guy. But these were the real names. Derek is currently in London.
Okay.
But Derek is a combination of Derek plus one more guy was Dubey. He was there. So he's a combination of Dubey was the gun who gave original speech.
Right, right.
So Devda is my batchmate. He is a prof in UCLA currently. Acid is a mix of again more guys. So was Mummy was junior to me. Sexa was my senior.
Sexa we all know, right? There's a everyone knows a Sexa if they're not one of themselves.
So, but the reason why I chose only these guys, there were 20 more more flamboyant characters than these guys.
Right.
But they were so niche. They were so niche. Matlab ki you would not really associate with them.
Right.
So I chose deliberately these guys who are everywhere. So yeah, that's why you also felt like that you've seen them.
Yeah.
Because that's how I chose when we're choosing the characters.
Sajid, you've said that you've been making movies for more than 35 years. You've said that this is one of your most special films, and you in fact dedicate producing this one to your son. Can you talk about that, and why, did you know from the moment that you're locked this idea that this is the film that Nitesh was going to make for you? Did you know that this one's going to pop? This one's going to.
That's the reason I stick my neck out. This because I wanted to tell this before 15 days. We didn't have much to publicize. As a producer, when the film completes, I need some kind of USPs to publicize the film.
Right.
I didn't have my actor was not doing well with the last film. There was no the item numbers.
Correct.
There's nothing I could actually. There were some emotions which I couldn't tell the audience.
Correct. Yeah, you can't.
So what I could tell the audience is a couple of things that the trailer is not justifying.
Right.
Whatever we make, we tried about a couple of months to make one. We could not crack a trailer which justifies the film. So the only kind of communication what I had with the audience is that this don't go by the trailer. This is what we could do at the time from 4 months we are making. And second, this is what I want to give it to my kids, because when I see the film, I'm not seeing myself in the college days. I don't know why. Somewhere I keep trying, but there's so many things. I've been just cut off and been making so many films day by day for the last 30 years. I need to go back. I need to, lie on my pillow and think about my days of college, which was those ragging days. But when I connect with the elder one, it's there because it's there 15 years.
What are some of the responses you've got to this stuff?
See, the response, it's very natural from my batchmates and my seniors and my juniors. Probably because there is a natural affinity.
Yeah.
So that doesn't come as a surprise. What has kind of taken me and my team and Sajid sir with surprise is the kind of blessings that have come our way. So that is something which I thought we've made a film and it tells an important message, but the way the film has got connected is something I honestly was not that prepared for, and the kind of love which the film has got is something which I will cherish for the rest of my life. I'll tell you one thing, I was at PVR Icon with all my cast and we were watching the film, and after the film got over, a lady came with her teenage son. She recognized us. And she was almost choking, and she said, "Thank you for making this film. Ye bachcha bahut pressure leta hai." Now that is a reward,
yeah.
It's a reward. You can't expect a bigger compliment than
Correct.
That. So yes, we're very happy with the kind of feedback we've got.